What's up, guys? Welcome back to the 10orShare channel. Have you ever run into a screen like this on your iPhone XR? The Apple logo shows up, then it disappears, and then shows up again. Just won't turn on as it normally does. In some cases, it could be frozen on the Apple logo. Anyway, how can we safely fix it without losing any data? Thank God, that is possible. In today's tutorial, we'll be going over the three most used methods. Let's dive in. First, it's highly recommended to give your phone a forced restart, which fixes a lot of issues by clearing system caches and temporary files. For iPhone XR, is press and quickly release the volume up button, then press and quickly release the volume down, then press and hold the side button. Release it when the Apple logo reappears. Okay, it doesn't seem to work. Let's move on to the next one. Update or reinstall iOS using iTunes. So once launch it on a laptop, plug the phone in. Then put it into recovery mode so iTunes can recognize it. Similar as the force restart, we press and release the volume up, then the volume down. This time we hold the side button a little bit longer till the connect to laptop icon shows up. Now iTunes should be asking if we want to update or restore. We prefer not to lose any data, so we choose the update. iTunes will be downloading the latest firmware, and then start updating the device. If everything goes swimmingly, you'll be able to see the home screen with all your data preserved. But if iTunes is giving you errors, you might want to consider restoring your phone to factory settings as it suggested. That will erase everything, but it does have a higher success rate. If you don't have any backup and are looking for alternatives, ReiBoot would be a nice choice. Let's go ahead and see how it works. We'll still need to enter recovery mode first. Then we get to home screen of ReiBoot and click on the start button. Then we'd want it to go with a standard repair so we can keep our data. Like iTunes, we'll be downloading the firmware, but this one allows you to change the download location. Once finished, we can start repairing. All we have to do is stay on a stable network and keep the phone attached during the process. In my case, it worked eventually, but if it didn't, you can try the standard repair a few more times before going with the advanced option. So that's it. Thanks for watching. I hope this video helps you guys. Have a nice day. See you.